Hello, everyone. How are you all? Good. I'm so pumped up, you know, because it's now 4 p.m. and I thought like most of you guys are going to leave because I thought you guys came on early in the morning. So I didn't expect to see like more than 10 people, but I'm so blessed. And I think big hands for you guys, please. Great to see the energy. So you guys already know that what is the topic I'm going to cover. Can I have a pointer? Okay, so we're going to talk about growth hacking. May I know how many of you heard the term growth hacking? Only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people. How many of you really know about growth hacking? It's not something about hacking someone's Facebook or your girlfriend's Facebook, definitely. If you come with that expectation, I'm sorry. Yeah. So how many of you exactly know what is growth hacking? Okay, don't know. I saw a nice voice. She said, don't know. Yeah. So the thing is, it's not a rocket science. This is something probably what we are doing. It's not something what we are not doing. We are doing, but we need to fine-tune it. So if we can fine-tune it, then it helps us to grow in a certain level. And this is what is growth hacking. And why growth hacking is being so popular? I think the startup culture or the small business is being so popular in recent past, right? If you see like in last 3 to 4 years, it's been a revolution in Malaysia. And not only in Malaysia, if you take a look on Philippines, any Southeast Asian country, I didn't do it. So yeah, so any Southeast Asian country, they're actually encouraging the startups. So when a lot of business are starting their operation, that means a lot of competition is starting, right? So if you need to sustain, you need to grow. And if you don't grow, and if you don't grow fast, then you'll be out of the game, right? And this is where actually the growth hacking comes. You need to grow fast, and you need to grow with a limited budget. So this is the importance of growth hacking. Let me introduce myself. I'm Nowrid. I know I look a bit brighter in here. There's no secret because I use a filter. And if you ask me which filter I use, actually I forget it because my wife chose it. She was just ensuring that I look more decent and nice. We all do that, right? Yeah, so it's okay. So currently I'm working with IQI, and I'm not only working with IQI, I'm also a digital marketing trainer, a public speaker. So you will see me speaking in like different places. So the first question, what is growth hacking? If I simplify it for you guys, I mean, I know that you guys love to take pictures of the slide. So I always try to make my slides less sexier so you guys can take my pictures instead of my slides. So yeah, I'm going to give you the slides, but let me simplify it. So growth hacking is if you're doing anything, not like usual. So like what happened, what we see in the marketing and sales, there's a big fight we are having between marketing and sales since I start working. I start seeing from that marketing said, we give them the best leads and they failed. And sales said, marketing sucks. They give us the like worst lead. That's why we couldn't make the sales, right? And at the end of the day, no one actually converting those leads. So this is where the growth hacker comes. The growth hacker is someone who is ensuring from A to Z, acquiring the customers to converting it and retain them. So this is what is growth hacker is doing. And to do that, he need to do it with some data. He cannot do it just blindly based on some data he is doing. And he need to do a lot of, you know, like experimentation. Probably you have tried 2 landing pages, it's not working. So you need to try another 2 landing page that is that works or not. So another thing, they're focusing only one thing, that is growth. I've seen a lot of companies, I don't know if you guys agree with me or not. Are you guys taking my picture? Tell me. Okay. So so a lot of companies actually focusing on likes and shares in social media, right? Even if like I'm very tired, I was saying my bosses, don't take a look on like how many likes you got, how many shares you got, but he's still a big fan of like likes and shares. I don't know, probably on the Friday night, he had like a competition with his friends while he is drinking. I'm not sure. So for a growth hacker, those like and share doesn't mean anything if it's not converting, if it's not giving you any business. You got 5,000 shares, but you haven't got any sales. This is what is not, I mean, the, you know, like sign of a growth hacker. Growth hacker ensures if you got 5 engagement, you should have got like 1 sales out of those 5 engagement. So this is what is growth hackers are doing. And growth hackers is not like, as I told you, like people think it's a rocket science, it's something different. It's not different. Growth hacker can help you to grow in marketing, in sales, in everywhere. Something you're doing already, he just did a tweak it, and you start growing on that particular moment. So this is what is growth hacker is doing. And another big thing they are doing, so imagine last year you have produced, I mean, you have got like 200 sales, and you have spent 1,000 ringgit. So growth hacker ensures that you are getting 250 sales by spending 1,000 ringgit. So this is what actually a growth hacker ensures. So who is growth hacker? So most of the people think the marketer is the growth hacker. How many of you, think the same? Okay, I see her hand. So most of the people I see, I talk, they feel like the marketer is the growth hacker. Even, you know, the growth hacker is also called as like the growth marketer. But the thing is, it's not necessary. If you want to be a growth hacker, you have to be a marketer. Anyone who is related with your product, your service, and who can make an impact, he or she can be the growth hacker. Doesn't matter if he's your operation manager or marketing manager or even your senior executive of marketing. He needs to ensure that he is following those process and ensuring the growth. So this is actually 100% solely for taking pictures, exclusively. So this is the stages of like growth hacking. So when a growth hacker starts working to ensure your growth, in which level they're making the impact, from acquisition to referral. So I'm not going to go through all these 5 slides because I know you guys are also amazing in marketing. Most of you are working in marketing and sales. So you guys are more or less familiar with these 5 steps. But still, if you think I'm trying to, I mean, slipping away, no. If you have question, you can always ask me. If you can't ask me the question on Q&A, I'm roaming around, so feel free to catch me. All right, so I decided not to make it too complex because I told you, I know you guys had a long, long, long day. So I tried to give you some simple tips, which you already know. It's something like, you know, hitting on the gym. Who knows, like, you should do gym? Everyone knows, right? That's why you didn't raise your hand. So glad to see that, because you don't have the energy. I can get it. So what happened? We know like we should hit to the gym at least 3 days in a week, but we don't do it. This is also a growth hacking. If you start doing gym, you can see the impact. So we know, but we are not doing it. So the things I'm going to cover, trust me, I swear to God, you already know that. But you are just not focusing it properly. So this is why I'm here. I'm not here to teach you anything. I'm just came here to make you guys aware that, guys, this is the little thing we are missing. And if you do it, you can make an impact. It will ensure you have the better conversion for your business. So let's see what is the first one. Focus on optimization and the load time. Who loves it if any website takes time to load for like 5 seconds? Do you know if anything takes more than 3 seconds, people start feeling frustrated according to statistics? I don't know about you guys, I'm feeling so frustrated. And if it's 5 seconds, I can't tell you what I'm doing. Like, so it's like I'm getting crazy. So the same thing, I give you some statistics. And let me tell you a real life example. That's what happened like just 3 weeks ago. I was talking with a client who is actually my friend. So they're running a Facebook campaign for a running event. And they got 6,000 plus clicks. So when your advertisement is getting 6,000 plus clicks, and per click is like only 12 cents. So in terms of if you see the numbers, it's like amazing. But the funny thing is, they got only 13 registration. So which is really, really super bad, right? And when I saw the ad was like tremendous. But the thing is, when I click on the ad, then I find the reason. It takes at least 5 to 6 seconds to bring me to the landing page. And I think this is where actually they're losing like 70 to 80% of their customer. And the rest of the 20% customer were really, 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 I would say like very gentle kind of people. That's why they spend like 7 seconds and see what is the landing page is. And those who have registered, they were desperately, you know, like interested about that event. Probably his mom's event, dad's event, I don't know. So somehow it's like related. So I asked them to tweak it and they work on it and the conversion increased 25% on the next week. Just because it gives people a better experience. It helps them to have a better conversion. So I know most of the Malaysian business don't care about the website. I know this is what I learned from my company as well. But that's why we are here. We need to educate people, right? We need to push people so they can do it. So if you change, if you ensure that your website is loading within 2 to 3 seconds, it will help you to increase your conversion. And the second thing, optimization. What I mean by optimization, that your website should be friendly with desktop, laptop, and like tablet, phone, everything. The second one, you see these two logos, right? Anyone here from Lazada or Shopee? Okay, thank you're from Shopee? Okay, I thought. Okay, first of all, don't judge me. I'm not going to say anything bad. I'm just going to share my own personal experience. I think the user experience really matters a lot. I love to buy stuff from online. But if you ask me which one I prefer between Lazada and Shopee, I prefer Lazada. By the way, I'm not saying I have all the loves and regards for Shopee. I really respect the way they work. I didn't say like they're bad, but it's like the user experience. If you ask me, I feel like the better experience I get on Lazada because every time I go to Shopee, it looks more cluttered to me. And again, I'm sorry, I'm not judging anyone who's from Shopee. I'm sincerely apologizing. It's just like my personal opinion. And I asked my wife, she got the same kind of feedback. So it looks a bit cluttered. And Lazada always gives me the better experience. But the funny thing is, the Shopee is delivering faster than Lazada, and they have like almost the same kind of products. So nothing exclusive between Lazada and Shopee. It's just the experience. That's why I prefer Lazada over Shopee. That's it. So it's clearly showing that as it's giving me the better experience, so it's helping them to have some extra sales, right? Okay, so the next one. Pixels. How many of you know about Facebook pixels? Okay, a lot of fans. So those who don't know, let me tell you a story. The moment you go to Zalora, Lazada, or Shopee, and then you leave that website, you go back to Facebook, and then you start seeing they start chasing you with the advertisement, right? And they keep chasing you until you die, I guess. Right? So this is what actually Pixel is doing, because when you're having a lot of traffic in your website, 90% of them actually forget about you. They actually distracted by a lot of things. Because, you know, social media is now a big distraction for us, right? But I see that distraction as a positive note. I know some of you are seeing it as negative, but I see it as a very positive note. So whenever they come to your website, so if 98% are not coming back, you need to reach them, right? Because they have some certain interest. And to do that, you need to use Pixel. If you use Pixel, then only you can reach those audience in social media who have visited your website. And from my experience, and if you go like through the blogs, when you use the Pixels for remarketing, it actually gives you 21% better conversion compared with the new audience. So I think you guys can try and you can come up. If you're not getting successful, please feel free to drop me the text. I'll try to help you guys. The next one, lookalike audience. Who knows about lookalike audience? Wow, impressive. So those who don't know, just let me tell you, it's like if I'm buying from Lazada, then Facebook will find similar people like me who have the same tendency. Because, you know, when Facebook is delivering the ads, they actually do it based on the AI. They based on it deliver based on your behavior. So if you want to, if you're frustrated that, okay, I'm not getting enough sales from social media ads, I'm not getting better response from social media ads, my price is getting higher and higher, I'm telling you, try this. It's really effective. My 6 months ago, every lead cost for me was like 7 ringgit. Now it becomes like 5 ringgit 35 cents, which is 2 ringgit lesser. And the conversion rate is, at least 50% better than before. I'm getting more quality leads and better sales as well. Because when you get the quality leads, eventually you have the opportunity to get the sales, right? Because nowadays you see a lot of people are making complaint that, oh, whenever I'm getting leads from Facebook, they are not quality. They're not receiving my phone, right? So use the this one, the lookalike audience and custom audience. Trust me, it will help you to have a better conversion. And you can create the lookalike audience from custom audience. So you need a custom audience, and then from there you can actually create a lookalike audience. Okay. Who knows about Damakan? Okay, my next question. Who buy just because they give you 20 ringgit discount? So I raise my hand as well, you see? Okay, so the last time when I buy from them, it was on last April. And then, a week ago, they sent me 3 coupon. First one is 20 ringgit, second one is 10 ringgit, third one is 8 ringgit. And they said if I share it on my social media or with my friend, I will eligible to get another 5 coupon for like 5 ringgit. So I order for like 3 days food. And I also influence my wife, so she can also order, because she also eligible for some certain discount if I refer her. So you see, if they have like 10 sales because of the discount, they're having now like 16 sales. Because they make you an offer which you cannot avoid, which you cannot like ignore. Because the meal is like 25 ringgit, and if you're getting 20 ringgit discount, 5 ringgit per meal, you can't even get so cheap meal even in the Mamak, right? So I instantly ordered it, and I ordered 3 days in a row. And then I stopped. I'm just expecting more, you know, like promos from them. Probably if I stop for like another 2 weeks, they will send me some more promo code. So this is also another way. The Grab is a great example. When I came in Malaysia, Grab gives me the promo code every day and night. So I was so habituated with the promo code, and then they did it for a year. And now every time I take taxi, I take Grab. Even if there's like MyCar, Moola, and a lot of things, but I always go for GrabCar because it comes in my top of mind. So this is how you can do the growth hacking actually. Offer something that people cannot deny. They have to come and jump into it. Okay. If you want to, yes, I know I have 5 minutes. Okay. So if you really want to grow in social media, I think you should look for like different channels. Do you know how many people are using internet in Malaysia? No shame, I'm telling you, 25 million people. And out of 25 million people, 25 million people are using Facebook. 100% people are using Facebook. So no wonder that's why the Facebook becomes so cluttered and you're feeling so competition. So you definitely should find a different social media platform where you have, it's not too cluttered and it's suitable for your business as well. So I can refer you to social media platform. One is LinkedIn and one is Twitter. And those who think Twitter's are, because last time when I was talking to a place, they said, oh, Nowrid, you know, like Twitter only used by the politicians. I mean, true, they're your target market, right? They have the money. As simple as that, they have the money. But the second thing is, this is the recent data I pulled yesterday. If you see the fastest growing profiles in Malaysia, there's 5 profiles you can see. How many of them are politicians? I think 2. Right? And count Mr. Mahathir as a politician because he's like the, he's everyone's heart. So he's more than a politician to every Malaysian, right? So if you see, Niloufar, she's are actually an influencer. And first two is like the AFC Championship. I don't know, like it's probably something related with football. So these all are the fastest growing pages in Twitter. So those who think it's only for the politicians, no one having fun in Twitter, trust me, it's not like that. And if you ask me which social media can give you the better conversion apart from Facebook, I highly believe in LinkedIn. It's my favorite social media platform. Twitter and definitely Instagram. Just take an example. Like a year back, people wasn't very familiar with Instagram. They weren't using the Instagram ads, but now everyone is doing the Instagram ads, right? So you have to be an early bird and you need to take the advantage of it. Like if you buy the early bird ticket, you'll always get the discount, right? So something like that. So I think you should explore Twitter and you should explore LinkedIn. And those who are not exploring Instagram, come on, do it now. It's too late already. Okay. This is the best part. I mean, I like it, the social proof. I don't know about you guys, but every time I want to buy a phone or any gadget, or if I want to go to any restaurant, I actually check for the reviews or I check for the YouTube reviews. How many of you do similar things like me? Yes, you see? People don't trust the advertisement anymore. People likes people. People loves people. That's why the personal brand is growing. That's why the Instagram story is becoming so popular, because I can see what my friend is wearing today, from where she buy the new shoes, where she is going to eat, XYZ, right? So I think the social proof is really effective. The moment you use the social proof, it gives you the better conversion. And the example, you can see the Adspresso. So Adspresso, MailChimp, Shopify, they use HubSpot as well. They all are using like the social proof to build their business. So even I end up buying with Adspresso just because I saw their social proof. They show something like in Malaysia, 15,000 marketers are using Adspresso. So that's how actually social proof works. And as we are also looking for the reviews, so no doubt it's one of the most effective thing for your business. Okay. At the very beginning, I said one thing. If you want to grow, you need to do an A-B test. I always say one thing, that there is no standard we have in digital marketing. If anyone is telling you that this is a certain way, you should follow and you can get an amazing results, either he is telling lie or he don't know what he is telling. Because it's very hard to make a guess what is the steps you should follow in digital marketing, because it's constantly changing. It's changing every day and every night. And the second thing is, you know, different business has like different behaviors, but then you can say like, so shouldn't we go and take any suggestions? Yeah, you should take suggestions. You should follow, you should know the best practices, and you should test and try which one is work for you. Whatever is work for you, it might not work for your friend. So do a lot of testing. Different landing page even can bring you like the different results. So when you're running a campaign, conversion campaign, you should try multiple landing page and you can check out the results. And there's a statistics I have seen from a form, the registration form. If you take just like a question, if you just remove a question from there, you are getting 26% more conversion. So people are so lazy, they don't want to type. They don't want to fill anything. So the lesser information you will ask, the higher chance you will get the better conversion. So I'm going to end with a story with Dropbox. I'm not sure how many minutes I've left, but I believe there's one or two more minutes left. So they did something. They actually increased 500% more user within like, I think, 3 to 4 months. And what they did, so when you register for the Dropbox, you are eligible to get a certain space, right? And then they will ask you, if you share it to your friend, and if they also join in Dropbox, you're eligible to get 500 MB for like each joiner. So that's how actually Dropbox made a revelation, and they increased their conversion. Like, I forget the exact numbers. It's 300 or like 500% more than the previous year. So it's just like referral. So what we see nowadays a lot in social media, like if you share my video, you're eligible to get and win this award, right? So that's why people start sharing those stuff. Like who is sharing more this video, he is eligible to get and win this offer, X, Y, Z. So something like that they also did back on that time. And this is one of the historic example, I mean, we have on like growth hacking. So I know we went through a lot of things, and 95% of the things you have already forget. It makes sense, because after 15 minutes, people cannot remember what they have listened before. So if you forget everything, just remember one thing. If you want to be a growth hacker, you need to focus on four things. First, you need to acquire consumer. Second, you need to convert them, because there's no point of having a customer if you're not converting them as a sales. And third, you need to retain them, because if you're not retaining them, probably Shopee will take it. So if Lazada is not giving me enough love and care, I'll be the Shopee customer from like next month. And then number four is advocate. You should, you know, like do the advocacy to your consumer, why they should stick with you and how you can add value to them. So if you follow these four steps on a regular basis, if you make it a cycle, then trust me, you will have the better conversion and you can keep doing it on a regular basis. So I think that's all from me. If you guys have any question, please feel free to ask me here, or if you want, you can ask me in any of my social media. I'm very active. I eat, live, and drink there. So usually if you have any question, I will reply you within 24 hours. If I'm not replying you back within 24 hours, that means I'm dead. So yeah, I hope you guys had a great time. Oh, you got a question, right? Should I go through it? Okay. What do you mean by the term user experience regarding Lazada, Shopee? Is it design, website speed, or whole purchasing process? Okay, you know, like why we use Android? Because it's easy to use, right? This is something, I mean, anyone can understand. So when I use Shopee, I feel like this is not something I understand. I need to think a little, which I don't want, because I told you, like, as a consumer, we are very lazy. We don't want to think. We want you to help me. So whenever I see Shopee, I can't explain you, but I feel like this is not, I mean, I need to do a lot of things. I don't know why. Even I tried to buy, but the experience wasn't actually better. So, but the user experience means how easy to navigate it is. How easy that website, I mean, how easy you can navigate that website. The second one, customer buying journey in B2B is long and complicated. What are your recommended strategy improving the conversion? Okay, for B2B, honestly, yeah, it's a long and complicated process. But for B2B, I have a suggestion to you that you should, I mean, use the custom audience and lookalike audience. If you're running the social media ads and if you're looking for the conversion through social media, then definitely you should focus on the pixels, custom audience, and lookalike audience. It will definitely help you to have a better conversion. And you can also try LinkedIn as well. What tools you use for growth hacking? I use a lot of tools, like Adspresso is one of them. So if you use Adspresso, you can see a lot detail of your advertisement, which you can't see generally from your ad manager. I use HubSpot for inbound marketing and to lead management. And then I used to use Hootsuite, but recently we get rid of like Hootsuite and we start using Zoho Social because it helps us to managing all the social media page and it saves a lot of time. So yeah, there's a lot of tools that are available into the market. You can try. Where do I learn growth hacking? Any online resources? Definitely you have the online resources. You should try edx.org. EDX.org, this is one of the best platform I see for like the online courses, so you can try and explore it. What industry, how much your company grow using growth hacking? Is it only for startup? Okay, it's mainly focused on startup because startup has a limited budget. So that's why the growth hacking is more popular for the startups, but definitely if you're a big company, but you're stuck with the growth, and if you make it happen, then definitely it's also applicable for the big businesses as well. There's no like certain rules that, oh, it's only for the startups. And how much my company grow using growth hacking. I just give you like one status because I cannot tell you in detail because there's a lot of like privacy issue we have. In terms of like conversion, we are having 75% better conversion compared with like last January. So 75% better conversion if I compare with 2019 January to 2019 August. Okay, what industry was lead from for around RM5? Just curious to know. Oh, I'm from like real estate industry. Yeah, I know it will shock you because 5 ringgit for real estate industry is like so cheap. Yeah. Because nowadays people are spending 15 to 20 ringgit to get a lead. What software do you use for your A-B test? Honestly, I don't use any app for doing the A-B test. So when I do the A-B test, I usually see the Google Analytics or Facebook Analytics or Advert Manager Analytics because I'm more like a performance marketing manager. So I'm more involved with the ad managers rather than using the different tools. But sometimes I use Adspresso because I told you Adspresso can give you a lot more detail than the ad managers. Awesome. So I hope you guys enjoy it. If you like me, give me a big hands. Thank you.